This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Decisive Turkish victory. Population exchange between the two nations. End of Greek presence in Anatolia and most of East Thrace. Treaty of Lausanne. Territorial changes. Lands initially ceded to Greece from the Ottoman Empire are incorporated into the Republic of Turkey. Belligerents. Grand National Assembly. Kuva Ye Millie 1919-1920. Materiel support. Soviet Russia. Mustafa Kemal Pasha. Fevzi Pasha. İsmet Pasha. Fahrettin Pasha. Kemalettin Sami Pasha. Yorick Ali Efe. Yusuf İzzet Pasha. Mehmet Arif Pasha. Mehmet Nazim Pasha. Mehmet Atif Pasha. Ali Fuat Pasha. Serkez Ethem Mahitin Pasha. Natsif Pasha. Savat Pasha. Jamil Pasha. Naci Pasha. Mumtaz Pasha. Kazim Pasha. Osman Nuri Pasha. Munip Pasha. Suleyman Pasha. Rustu Pasha. Sefik Pasha. Kazim Pasha. Nihat Pasha. Constantine I of Greece. Konstantinos Niter. Konstantinos Miliotis. Kaminos Leonidas. Periskavopoulos. Dimitrios Gonaris. Anastasios Papoulos. Georgios Hatsianestis. Nikolaos Trikopas. Georgios Polymenikos. Strength. May 1919 to 35,000. November 1920 to 86,000. August 1921 to 92,000. August 1922 to 208,000 men. Organization 1922. 18 infantry divisions, 5 cavalry divisions, 3 independent regiments. Equipment 1922 93,000 rifles, 2025 light machine guns, 839 heavy machine guns, 323 cannons, 5,282 swords, 198 trucks, 33 cars and ambulances, 10 aircraft. May 1919 to 15,000. April 1920 to 90,000. January 1921 to 100,000. June 1921 to 200,000. 1922 to 215,000. Organization 1922. 12 infantry divisions, 1 cavalry division, 9 independent regiments. Equipment 1922 130,000 rifles, 3,139 light machine guns, 1,280 heavy machine guns, 418 cannons, 1,300 swords, 4,036 trucks, 1,776 cars and ambulances, 50 aircraft casualties. And losses. Regular Army, 9,167 killed, 2,474 died of wounds or non-combat causes, 31,097 wounded, 11,150 missing, 6,522 prisoners, 19,362 killed, 4,878 died outside of combat, 48,880 wounded, 18,095 missing, approximately 13,740 prisoners. According to Turkish sources, 20,826 Greek prisoners were taken. Of those, about 740 officers and 13,000 soldiers arrived in Greece during the prisoner exchange in 1923. The rest presumably died in captivity and are listed among the missing. Greece took 22,071 military and civilian prisoners. Of those, were 520 officers and 6,002 soldiers during the prisoner exchange in 1923, 329 officers, 6,002 soldiers and 9,410 civilian prisoners arrived in Turkey. The remaining 6,330, mostly civilian prisoners, presumably died in Greek captivity. The Turkish Grand National Assembly was opened in 1920. Kuva Ye Millie operated independently between 1919-20 until it was put under the control of the Grand National Assembly VE. Turkish War of Independence. Greco-Turkish War. Greek landing at Smyrna. Occupation. URLA Malgic Bergama Erbali Erikli Teledidi Aydin. Akbaş 1920 Summer Offensive. Gedi's 1st Anonu 2nd Anonu. Eskişehir Sakarya Great Offensive. Dumlupinar Liberation of Smyrna. Turkish Armenian War. Oltu Sarıkamış Kars Alexandropol Franco Turkish War. Marış Urfa. Aintab Karbogazi Kanligasit Revolts. Ahmet Anzaver İzmit Gaiv Konya Kokgiri Naval Samson. The Greco-Turkish War of 1919-1922, known as the Western Front. Turkish Badi Sefesi of the Turkish War of Independence in Turkey and the Asia Minor Campaign. Greek Mikrasiatic Ekstrateia or the Asia Minor Catastrophe. Greek Mikrasiatic Catastrophe in Greece was fought between Greece and the Turkish National Movement during the partitioning of the Ottoman Empire after World War I. Between May 1919 and October 1922, the Greek campaign was launched primarily because the Western Allies, particularly British Prime Minister David Lloyd George had promised Greece territorial gains at the expense of the Ottoman Empire. Recently defeated in World War I, the armed conflict started when the Greek forces landed in Smyrna, now Izmir. On 15 May 1919, they advanced inland and took control of the western and northwestern part of Anatolia, including the cities of Manisa, Balıkesir, Aydın, Kütahya, Bursa, and Eskişehir. Their advance was checked at the Battle of Sakarya in 1921 by forces of the Turkish National Movement. The Greek front collapsed with the Turkish counterattack in August 1922, and the war effectively ended with the capture of Smyrna by the Turkish forces and the Great Fire of Smyrna. As a result, the Greek government accepted the demands of the Turkish National Movement and returned to its pre-war borders, thus leaving East Thrace and western Anatolia to Turkey. The Allies abandoned the Treaty of Sèvres to negotiate a new treaty at Lausanne with the Turkish National Movement. The Treaty of Lausanne recognized the independence of the Republic of Turkey and its sovereignty over Asia Minor, Constantinople, and Eastern Thrace. Greek and Turkish governments agreed to engage in a population exchange. Contents 1. Background 11. Geopolitical context 12. The Greek community in Anatolia. 13. Greek nationalism 14. The national schism in Greece 2. Greek expansion 21. Landing at Smyrna May 1919 22. Greek summer offensives summer 1920 23. Treaty of Sèvres August 1920 24. Greek advance October 1920 25. Change in Greek government November 1920 26. Battles of Annonou December 1920 4. Resolution 41. Factors contributing to the outcome 5. Atrocities and claims of ethnic cleansing by both sides 51. Greek massacres of Turks 52. Greek scorched earth policy 53. Turkish massacres of Greeks and Armenians 6. See also 7. Notes 71. References 72. Bibliography 8. External links. Background. Geopolitical context. Main article. Partitioning of the Ottoman Empire. Further information. Agreement of Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne. Map of Megali. Idea. The geopolitical context of this conflict is linked to the partitioning of the Ottoman Empire, which was a direct consequence of World War I and involvement of the Ottomans in the Middle Eastern theater. The Greeks received an order to land in Smyrna by the Triple Entente as part of the partition. During this war, the Ottoman government collapsed completely and the Ottoman Empire was divided amongst the victorious Entente powers. With the signing of the Treaty of Sèvres on August 10, 1920, there were a number of secret agreements regarding the partitioning of the Ottoman Empire at the end of World War I. The Triple Entente had made contradictory promises about post-war arrangements concerning Greek hopes in Asia Minor at the Paris Peace Conference, 1919, Eleftherios Venizelos lobbied hard for an expanded Hellas. The Megali idea that would include the large Greek communities in northern Epirus, Thrace and Asia Minor. The Western Allies, particularly British Prime Minister David Lloyd George, had promised Greece territorial gains at the expense of the Ottoman Empire if Greece entered the war on the Allied side. These included Eastern Thrace, the islands of Imbros Imras, since 29 July 1979 Gökçeada and Tenedo Bozkada, and parts of western Anatolia around the city of Smyrna, which contained sizable ethnic Greek populations. The Italian and Anglo-French repudiation of the Agreement of Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne signed on April 26, 1917, which settled the «Middle Eastern interest» of Italy, was overridden with the Greek occupation. As Smyrna Izmir was part of the territory promised to Italy before the occupation, the Italian delegation to the Paris Peace Conference, 1919, angry about the possibility of the Greek occupation of western Anatolia, left the conference and did not return to Paris until May 5. The absence of the Italian delegation from the conference ended up facilitating Lloyd George's efforts to persuade France and the United States to support Greece and prevent Italian operations in western Anatolia. According to some historians, it was the Greek occupation of Smyrna that created the Turkish National Movement. Arnold J. Toynbee argues, the war between Turkey and Greece, which burst out at this time, was a defensive war for safeguarding of the Turkish homelands in Anatolia. It was a result of the Allied policy of imperialism operating in a foreign state, the military resources and powers of which were seriously underestimated. It was provoked by the unwarranted invasion of a Greek army of occupation. According to others, the landing of the Greek troops in Smyrna was part of Eleftherios Venizelos's plan, inspired by the Megali idea, to liberate the large Greek populations in the Asia Minor. Smyrna up to the Great Fire of Smyrna had a bigger Greek population than the Greek capital, Athens. Athens, before the population exchange between Greece and Turkey, had a population of 473,000, while Smyrna, according to Ottoman sources, in 1910, had a Greek population exceeding 629,000. The Greek community in Anatolia. Main article, Greeks in Turkey. Distribution of nationalities in Ottoman Empire. Anatolia, Ottoman official statistics, 1910. Provinces: Turks, Greeks, Armenians, Jews, others. Total: Istanbul, Asiatic Shore 135,681, 70,906, 30,465, 5,120, 16,812, 258,984. Izmit 184,960. 78,564, 50,935, 2,180, 1,435, 318,074. Aydın İzmir 974,225, 629,002, 17,247, 24,361, 58,076, 1,702,911. Bursa 1,346,387, 274,530, 87,932, 2,788, 6,125. 1,717,762. Konya 1,143,335, 85,320, 9,426, 720, 15,356, 1,254,157. Ankara 991,666, 54,280, 101,388, 901, 12,329, 1,160,564. Trabzon 1,047,889, 351,104. 45,094, 1,444,087. Shivas 933,572, 98,270, 165,741, 1,197,583. Kastamonu 1,086,420, 18,160, 3,061 to 1,980, 1,109,621. Adana 212,454, 88,010, 81,252, 107,240, 488,954. Biga 136,000, 29,000, 2,000, 3,398, 170,398. Total percent 8,192,589, 757%. 1,777,146, 1,642%, 594,539, 55%, 39,370, 36%, 219,451, 203%, 10,823,095. Ecumenical Patriarchate Statistics, 1912. Total percent 7,048,662, 727%, 1,788,582, 1,845%, 608,707, 628%. 37,523, 039%, 218,102, 225%, 9,695,506. One of the reasons proposed by the Greek government for launching the Asia Minor expedition was that there was a sizable Greek-speaking Orthodox Christian population inhabiting Anatolia that needed protection. Greeks had lived in Asia Minor since antiquity, and before the outbreak of World War I, up to 25 million Greeks lived in the Ottoman Empire. The suggestion that the Greeks constituted the majority of the population in the lands claimed by Greece has been contested by a number of historians. Cedric James Lowe and Michael L. Dockrell also argued that Greek claims about Smyrna were at best debatable, since Greeks constituted perhaps a bare majority, more likely a large minority in the Smyrna Vilayet, which lay in an overwhelmingly Turkish Anatolia. Precise demographics are further obscured by the Ottoman policy of dividing the population according to religion rather than descent, language, or self-identification. On the other hand, contemporaneous British and American statistics 1919 support the point that the Greek element was the most numerous in the region of Smyrna, counting 375,000, while Muslims were 325,000. Greek Prime Minister Venizelos stated to a British newspaper that Greece is not making war against Islam, but against the anachronistic Ottoman government, and its corrupt, ignominious, and bloody administration, with a view to expelling it from those territories where the majority of the population consists of Greeks. To an extent, the above danger may have been overstated by Venizelos as a negotiating card on the table of Sèvres, in order to gain the support of the Allied governments. For example, the Young Turks were not in power at the time of the war, which makes such a justification less straightforward. Most of the leaders of that regime had fled the country at the end of World War I, and the Ottoman government in Constantinople was already under British control. Furthermore, Venizelos had already revealed his desires for annexation of territories from the Ottoman Empire in the early stages of World War I, before these massacres had taken place. In a letter sent to Greek King Constantine in January 1915, he wrote that, "I have the impression that the concessions to Greece in Asia Minor committed by both sides during and after the war, the Greeks of Pontus and the Turks of the Greek-occupied territories, were in some degree victims of Mr. Venizelos's and Mr. Lloyd George's original miscalculations at Paris." Greek nationalism main article, Megali Idea: the Greek Kingdom and the Greek Diaspora in the Balkans and Western Asia Minor. According to a 1919 Greek map submitted to the Paris Peace Conference, one of the main motivations for initiating the war was to realize the Megali Great Idea, a core concept of Greek nationalism. The Megali Idea was an irredentist vision of a restoration of a greater Greece on both sides of the Aegean that would incorporate territories with Greek populations outside the borders of the Kingdom of Greece, which was initially very small from the time of Greek independence from the Ottoman Empire in 1830. The Megali Idea had played a major role in Greek politics. Greek politicians, since the independence of the Greek state, had made several speeches on the issue of the historic inevitability of the expansion of the Greek kingdom. For instance, Greek politician Ioannis Kaledis voiced this conviction in the assembly in 1844. There are two great centers of Hellenism: Athens as the capital of the kingdom, Constantinople as the great capital, the city, the dream and hope of all Greeks. The great idea was not merely the product of 19th-century nationalism, it was, in one of its aspects, deeply rooted in many Greeks' religious consciousnesses. This aspect was the recovery of Constantinople for Christendom and the re-establishment of the Christian Byzantine Empire, which had fallen in 1453. Ever since this time, the recovery of Saint Sophia and the city had been handed down from generation to generation as the destiny and aspiration of the Greek Orthodox. The Megali Idea, besides Constantinople, included most traditional lands of the Greeks, including Crete, Thessaly, Epirus, Macedonia, Thrace, the Aegean Islands, Cyprus, the coastlands of Asia Minor and Pontus on the Black Sea. Asia Minor was an essential part of the Greek world and an area of enduring Greek cultural dominance. The Greek city-states and later the Byzantine Empire also exercised political control of most of the region, from the Bronze Age to the 12th century, when the first Seljuk Turk raids reached it. The national schism in Greece. See also, national schism. The national schism in Greece was the deep split of Greek politics and society between two factions, the one led by Eleftherios Venizelos and the other by King Constantine, that predated World War I but escalated significantly over the decision on which side Greece should support during the war. The United Kingdom had hoped that strategic considerations might persuade Constantine to join the cause of the Allies, but the king and his supporters insisted on strict neutrality. Especially whilst the outcome of the conflict was hard to predict. In addition, family ties and emotional attachments made it difficult for Constantine to decide which side to support during World War I. The king's dilemma was further increased when the Ottomans and the Bulgarians, both having grievances and aspirations against the Greek kingdom, joined the Central Powers. According to Queen Sophia, Constantine's dream of marching into the great city of Hagia Sophia at the head of the Greek army was still in his heart, and it appeared as if the king was ready to enter the war against the Ottoman Empire. The conditions, however, were clear. The occupation of Constantinople had to be undertaken without incurring excessive risk, though Constantine did remain decidedly neutral. Prime Minister of Greece Eleftherios Venizelos had from an early point decided that Greece's interests would be best served by joining the Entente, and started diplomatic efforts with the Allies to prepare the ground for concessions following an eventual victory. The disagreement and the subsequent dismissal of Venizelos by the king resulted in a deep personal rift between the two, which spilled over into their followers and the wider Greek society. Greece became divided into two radically opposed political camps, as Venizelos set up a separate state in northern Greece, and eventually, with allied support, forced the king to abdicate in May 1917. After the exile of Constantine, Venizelos returned to Athens and allied with the Entente Greek military forces, though divided between supporters of the monarchy and supporters of Venizelism, began to take part in military operations against the Bulgarian army on the border. The act of entering the war and the preceding events resulted in a deep political and social division in post-World War I Greece. The country's foremost political formations, the Venizelist liberals and the royalists, already involved in a long and bitter rivalry over pre-war politics, reached a state of outright hatred towards each other. Both parties viewed the other's actions during the First World War as politically illegitimate and treasonous. This enmity inevitably spread throughout Greek society, creating a deep rift that contributed decisively to the failed Asia Minor campaign and resulted in much social unrest in the inter-war years. Greek expansion map of the military developments until August 1922. The military aspect of the war began with the Armistice of Mudros. The military operations of the Greco-Turkish War can be roughly divided into three main phases. The first phase, spanning the period from May 1919 to October 1920, encompassed the Greek landings in Asia Minor and their consolidation along the Aegean coast. The second phase lasted from October 1920 to August 1921, and was characterized by Greek offensive operations. The third and final phase lasted until August 1922, when the strategic initiative was held by the Turkish army. Citation needed. Landing at Smyrna, May 1919. Main article: Greek landing at Smyrna. Arrival of Crown Prince George in Smyrna, 1919. Greek soldiers taking their posts in Smyrna. Turkish Izmir amidst the jubilant ethnic Greek population of the city. The 15th of May 1919. On May 15, 1919, 20,000 Greek soldiers landed in Smyrna and took control of the city and its surroundings under cover of the Greek, French, and British navies. Legal justifications for the landings was found in the Article 7 of the Armistice of Mudros, which allowed the Allies to occupy any strategic points in the event of any situation arising which threatens the security of Allies. The Greeks had already brought their forces into eastern Thrace apart from Constantinople and its region. The Christian population of Smyrna, mainly Greeks and Armenians, according to different sources, either formed a minority or a majority compared to Muslim Turkish population of the city. The Greek army also consisted of 2,500 Armenian volunteers. The majority of the Greek population residing in the city greeted the Greek troops as liberators. By contrast, the majority of the Muslim population saw this as an invading force, and some Turks resented the Greeks as a result of a long history of conflict and antagonism. Nevertheless, the Greek landings were received by and large passively, only facing sporadic resistance, mainly by small groups of irregular Turkish troops in the suburbs. The majority of the Turkish forces in the region either surrendered peacefully to the Greek army, or fled to the countryside. Greek summer offensives. Summer 1920. Main article: Greek summer offensive. During the summer of 1920, the Greek army launched a series of successful offensives in the directions of the Buyuk Menderes River Meander Valley, Karsiyaka Paramos, and Alashahir Philadelphia. The overall strategic objective of these operations, which were met by increasingly stiff Turkish resistance, was to provide strategic depth to the defense of Izmir. Smyrna. To that end, the Greek zone of occupation was extended over all of western and most of northwestern Anatolia. Treaty of Sevres. August 1920. Main article: Treaty of Sevres. Partition of the Ottoman Empire. According to the Treaty of Sevres, in return for the contribution of the Greek army on the side of the Allies supported the assignment of eastern Thrace and the millet of Smyrna to Greece. This treaty ended the First World War in Asia Minor and, at the same time, sealed the fate of the Ottoman Empire. Henceforth, the Ottoman Empire would no longer be a European power. On August 10, 1920, the Ottoman Empire signed the Treaty of Sevres, ceding to Greece Thrace, up to the Chatalia lines. More importantly, Turkey renounced to Greece all rights over Imbros and Tenedo, retaining the small territories of Constantinople, the islands of Marmara, and a tiny strip of European territory. The Straits of Bosporus were placed under an international commission, as they were now open to all. Turkey was furthermore forced to transfer to Greece the exercise of her rights of sovereignty over Smyrna, in addition to a considerable hinterland, merely retaining a flag over an outer fort. Though Greece administered the Smyrna enclave, its sovereignty remained, nominally, with the Sultan. According to the provisions of the treaty, Smyrna was to maintain a local parliament and, if within 5 years' time she asked to be incorporated within the Kingdom of Greece, the provision was made that the League of Nations would hold a plebiscite to decide on such matters. The treaty was never ratified by the Ottoman Empire or Greece. Greek advance October 1920. In October 1920, the Greek army advanced further east into Anatolia, with the encouragement of Lloyd George, who intended to increase pressure on the Turkish and Ottoman governments to sign the Treaty of Sevres. This advance began under the liberal government of Eleftherios Venizelos, but soon after the offensive began, Venizelos fell from power and was replaced by Dimitrios Gonaris. The strategic objective of these operations was to defeat the Turkish nationalists and force Mustafa Kemal into peace negotiations. The advancing Greeks, still holding superiority in numbers and modern equipment at this point, had hoped for an early battle in which they were confident of breaking up ill-equipped Turkish forces, yet they met with little resistance, as the Turks managed to retreat in an orderly fashion and avoid encirclement. Churchill said, "The Greek columns trailed along the country roads, passing safely through many ugly defiles, and at their approach the Turks, under strong and sagacious leadership, vanished into the recesses of Anatolia." Change in Greek government. November 1920. Anastasios Papoulas, commander-in-chief of the Greek army of Asia Minor. During October 1920, King Alexander was bitten by a monkey kept at the royal gardens and died within days from sepsis. This incident has been characterized as the monkey bite that changed the course of Greek history. Venizelos's preference was to declare a Greek republic and thus end the monarchy. However, he was well aware that this would not be acceptable to the European powers after King Alexander died without heirs. The general elections scheduled to be held on November 1, 1920 suddenly became the focus of a new conflict between the supporters of Venizelos and the royalists. The anti-Venizelist faction campaigned on the basis of accusations of internal mismanagement and authoritarian attitudes of the government, which, due to the war, had stayed in power without elections since 1915. At the same time, they promoted the idea of disengagement in Asia Minor, without though presenting a clear plan as to how this would happen. On the contrary, Venizelos was identified with the continuation of a war that did not seem to go anywhere. The majority of the Greek people were both war-weary and tired of the almost dictatorial regime of the Venizelists, so opted for change. To the surprise of many, Venizelos won only 118 out of the total 369 seats. The crushing defeat obliged Venizelos and a number of his closest supporters to leave the country. To this day, his rationale to call elections at that time is questioned. The new government under Dimitrios Gonaris prepared for a plebiscite on the return of King Constantine, noting the king's neutrality during World War I. The Allies warned the Greek government that if he should be returned to the throne, they would cut off all financial and military aid to Greece. A month later, a plebiscite called for the return of King Constantine. Soon after his return, the king replaced many of the World War I veteran officers and appointed inexperienced monarchist officers to senior positions. The leadership of the campaign was given to Anastasios Papoulas, while King Constantine himself assumed nominally the overall command. In addition, many of the remaining Venizelist officers resigned. Appalled by the regime change, the Greek army, which had secured Smyrna and the Asia Minor coast, was purged of Venizelos's supporters while it marched on Ankara. Battles of Annonu December 1920. Finally defeated the Greeks on March 30. The British favoured a Greek territorial expansion but refused to offer any military assistance in order to avoid provoking the French. Citation needed. The Turkish forces received significant assistance from Soviet Russia. Shift of support towards Turkish revolutionaries. Main article, Conference of London. See also, Treaty of Alexandropol, Treaty of Ankara 1921, and Treaty of Moscow 1921. By this time all other fronts had been settled in favour of the Turks, freeing more resources to focus on the main threat of the Greek army. The French and the Italians concluded private agreements with the Turkish revolutionaries in recognition of their mounting strength. Turkish revolutionaries bought equipment from Italy and France, who threw in their lot with the Turkish revolutionaries against Greece, which was seen as a British client. The Italians used their base in Antalya to assist, especially from the point of view of intelligence. The Turkish revolutionaries against the Greeks. There emerged a friendly relationship between the Bolshevik Russian SFSR and the Turkish revolutionaries, which was solidified under Treaty of Moscow in March 1921. The RSFSR supported Mustafa Kemal and his forces with money and ammunition. In 1920 alone, the government of Vladimir Lenin supplied the Kemalists with 6,000 rifles, over 5 million rifle cartridges, 17,600 projectiles, as well as 2,006 Years the amount of aid increased. Battle of Afyonkarahisar Eskishehir July 1921. See also, Battle of Afyonkarahisar Eskishehir. King Constantine decorating the victorious war flags outside Kutaya, 1921. Between 27 June and 20 July 1921, a reinforced Greek army of 9 divisions launched a major offensive, the greatest thus far, against the Turkish troops commanded by İsmet İnönü on the line of Afyonkarahisar Kutaya Eskişehir. The plan of the Greeks was to cut Anatolia in two, as the above towns were on the main rail lines connecting the hinterland with the coast. Eventually, after breaking the stiff Turkish defences, they occupied these strategically important centres instead of pursuing and decisively crippling the nationalists' military capacity. The Greek army halted in consequence, and despite their defeat, the Turks managed to avoid encirclement and made a strategic retreat on the east of the Sakarya River, where they organized their last line of defense. This was the major decision that sealed the fate of the Greek campaign in Anatolia. The state and army leadership, including King Constantine, Prime Minister Dimitrios Gonaris, and General Anastasios Papoulas, met at Kutaya, where they debated the future of the campaign. The Greeks, with their faltering morale rejuvenated, failed to appraise the strategic situation that favored the defending side. Instead, pressed for a final solution, the leadership was polarized into the risky decision to pursue the Turks and attack their last line of defense close to Ankara. The military leadership was cautious and requested for more reinforcements and time to prepare, but did not go against the politicians. Only a few voices supported a defensive stance, including Ioannis Metaxas. Constantine by this time had little actual power and did not argue either way. After a delay of almost a month that gave time to the Turks to organize their defense, 7 of the Greek divisions crossed east of the Sakarya River. Battle of Sakarya August and September 1921. Main article, Battle of Sakarya. Greek lithograph depicting the Battle of Sakarya following the retreat of the Turkish troops under İsmet İnönü in the Battle of Kutaya Eskişehir. The Greek army advanced afresh to the Sakarya River. Sangarios in Greek, less than 100. Household was required to provide a pair of underclothing, sandals. Meanwhile, the Turkish parliament, not happy with the performance of İsmet İnönü as the commander of the Western Front, wanted Mustafa Kemal and Chief of General Staff Fevzi Çakmak to take control. The advance of the Greek army faced fierce resistance, which culminated in the 21-day Battle of Sakarya. August 23 to September 13, 1921. The Turkish defense positions were centered on series of heights, and the Greeks had to storm and occupy them. The Turks held certain hilltops and lost others, while some were lost and recaptured several times over. Yet the Turks had to conserve men, for the Greeks held the numerical advantage. The crucial moment came when the Greek army tried to take Haymana, 40 kilometers south of Ankara, but the Turks held out. Greek advances into Anatolia had lengthened their lines of supply and communication, and they were running out of ammunition. The ferocity of the battle exhausted both sides, but the Greeks were the first to withdraw to their previous lines. The thunder of cannon was plainly heard in Ankara throughout the battle. That was the furthest in Anatolia the Greeks would advance, and within few weeks they withdrew in an orderly manner back to the lines that they had held in June. The Turkish parliament awarded both Mustafa Kemal and Fevzi Çakmak with the title of Field Marshal for their service in this battle. To this day, no other person has received this 5-star general title from the Turkish Republic. Stalemate. September 1921. By threatening their positions in Constantinople, but this never materialized. The occupation of Constantinople would have been an easy task at this time, because the Allied troops garrisoned there were much fewer than the Greek forces in Thrace. 2 divisions. The end result, though, was instead to weaken the Greek defenses in Smyrna by withdrawing troops. The Turkish forces, on the other hand, were recipients of significant assistance from Soviet Russia. On 29 April, the Soviet authorities supplied the Turkish consul critical quantities of arms and ammunition, sufficient for 3 Turkish divisions. On 3 May, the Soviet government handed over 33,500,000 gold rubles to Turkey, the balance of the credit of 10 million gold rubles. Voices in Greece increasingly called for withdrawal, and demoralizing propaganda spread among the troops. Some of the removed Venizelist officers organized a movement of national defense and planned a coup to secede from Athens, but never gained Venizelos's endorsement, and all their actions remained fruitless. Historian Malcolm Yap wrote that, after the failure of the March negotiations, the obvious course of action for the Greeks was to withdraw to defensible lines around Izmir, but at this point fantasy began to direct Greek policy. The Greeks stayed in their positions and planned a seizure of Constantinople, although this latter project was abandoned in July in the face of Allied opposition. Turkish counterattack. Dumlupinar. Further information, Battle of Dumlupinar. Play media. Mustafa Kemal with the Turkish revolutionaries before the counterattack. The Turks finally launched a counterattack on August 26, what has come to be known to the Turks as the Great Offensive Buyukteras. The major Greek defense positions were overrun on August 26, and Afyon fell next day on August 30. The Greek army was defeated decisively at the Battle of Dumlupinar, with half of its soldiers captured or slain and its equipment entirely lost. This date is celebrated as Victory Day, a national holiday in Turkey, and Salvage Day of Kutaya. During the Battle of Dumlupinar, Greek General Nikolaos Trikopis and General Dionys were captured by the Turkish forces. General Trikopis learned only after his capture that he had been recently appointed commander-in-chief in General Hatzianestis's place on September 1. Mustafa Kemal issued his famous order to the Turkish army: "Armies, your first goal is the Mediterranean. Forward, Turkish advance on Smyrna." Further information, Turkish advance on Smyrna and Great Fire of Smyrna on September 2, Eskişehir was captured, and the Greek government asked Britain to arrange a truce that would at least preserve its rule in Smyrna. Balıkesir and Bilecik were taken on.